Hello and welcome to what's this tutorial. So in this tutorial I will show you how to create 3D object like this. And I can show you, so there is, we are using this canvas for dimensions. So let's start. Here's that same canvas, I have already imported it. So you can import canvas from here, clicking there canvas. So first we have to calibrate this, selecting here calibrate, then top view, and we can use this dimension for calibration. And then there is 36 millimeters, so we select it here. So now it should be calibrated and we can start using that. So we create new sketch here. Then we can start drawing this thing. We don't have to add any dimensions yet. We can just draw things here. Okay. Then we can here the other and here. So now there should be, and then we can use this same circle tool for here and there. So, and then that's there, and then there is also a circle. Okay, so, and then we can press L. Now we can draw a line here. So holding this mouse button down, we can do line which is attached to tangent lines. Like that, now it's there, tangent. So if we press Esc and if we move this, we can see that's attached there. If that's not working, we can just draw a line here, somewhere like how we want. Then press Esc and choose this, click a line and there, and again there, and now it's again attached there. Same thing here, other side, press L and like that, and then here is same thing, that. And I think now it's fine, so we can start creating construction line. So I press L and then X for construction line. Click here and there. And we know they have to be, this have to choose here. So now it's like that. And then we could some dimensions here. We know that's 50, so we can click there and there, and then 50 here, and then we know this thing should be also, and we can click here and press X, and then that one. And then we could do add some dimensions here. So this one is, it's air 20, so diameter is 40. And this one is 32, so its diameter is 64. Here it's 8.5, so it's, we can do it like this if we want, 8.5, it's 17, and there 15 is 30. Okay, now we could add dimensions here. So air 5, it's 10, and air 30. It's 26, And then we can use this equal tool here. So we click this and then we click here. So now they are same dimension and same thing here. And then what's this thing? This should be here. And then we can add this, it's 31. So dimension tool and not that, 62. Then we can attach this thing. It's here and there. And then we can attach this thing. It's there and there. It's air 15. Now we can trim this thing's bit. So it's there, there, and there. And I don't know if there is some. Now we can click here and we want it attached tangent like that. And now we can add that radius, it's air 15. So 15. And this one should be 36. And then we can do same trim here. That. And this one is air 20. And then we have to do same trim here. There, 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 there. And there is 62. And now we could attach this here. So it's all blue now, so we don't know which is correct. There is, it's 65. Let's add that there. So every this blue lines we have to change them black so we know they are constraint. Then let's try, that's not correct. So we need construction line here. And it's attached there and this is horizontal. So now it's all constraint. And it looks there is everything. Correct. We can trim this because there shouldn't be that. And yeah, we can trim this thing also. Now it looks correct. So then we can use mirror tool here, and then we just click everything we want to mirror. Other side. And then this mirror line, and we use this. And then we can hide that. So now it's mirrored, and we can see that if we create change here, like let's say 45, it goes there. And now it's all correct, and then we can start, we can do some basic extrusion here. So we can create this like 5, and then we can hide these bodies and we can write 7 here. And let's use join operation. Okay. We can hide sketch. So now it's there. We can transfer here. Or not there. We can click here. Okay, and then we can change this Visual style, let's use Okay, so now it looks correct. So thank you for watching.